We all know Boeing 737 MAX has been grounded post two major fatal accidents in which a total of 346 people died. Boeing is working hard to bring back this aircraft back to the skies soon, post making all required changes and fixes in it. Due to these two major accidents, the aviation regulators around the world grounded the Boeing 737 MAX for about 15 months now. The Boeing 737 MAX is a narrow-body aircraft series designed and produced by Boeing Commercial Airplanes as the fourth generation of the Boeing 737, which succeeds the Boeing 737 Next Generation model. The two airlines which were the victim were Lion Air Flight 610, which crashed on October 29, 2018, killing 189 people. The other one was Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302, which crashed on March 10, 2019, killing 157 people. The reason for these crashes were due to a false report which was triggered by an automated system known as Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System, or MCAS. The MCAS takes reading from two sensors that determine how much the plane's nose is pointing up or down relative to the oncoming airflow. When MCAS detects that the plane is pointing up at a dangerous angle, it can automatically push down the nose of the plane in an effort to prevent the plane from stalling. Based on more investigations, it was found that there was a problem with this particular maneuvering characteristics augmentation system, and the investigation was continued in that particular angle. Due to these two crashes of 737 MAX aircrafts, it made the plane being grounded indefinitely, and Boeing hasn't sold any 737 MAX in months for now. Since the grounding, Boeing expected the 737 MAX planes to return to service very soon, and according to them, it would be done in a phased manner. Now, the latest update on the 737 MAX is that the FAA confirmed on Sunday, June 28, 2020, in an email to the United States Congress that it had approved the key certification test flights for the grounded 737 MAX. Over the past several weeks, the FAA has been reviewing the system safety assessment which was submitted by Boeing, and FAA's Type Inspection Authorization Board has completed its review and clearing the way for flight certification testing to begin. The FAA will have one of its test pilots flying the plane alongside a Boeing pilot. They will be accompanied in the cockpit by an FAA flight test engineer and a Boeing flight test manager. Additional specialists will be in the cabin monitoring the computerized instrumentation on the plane. Even if this test flight process is successful, further flying, training of pilots, and clearance from the European and Canadian regulators will be needed. It will take months for the agency to complete the new pilot training standards and issue regulations governing multiple software and hardware changes to the plane. The certification flights are scheduled to occur over three separate days. The agency, which worked closely with Boeing during the process of revising the plane, has a list of maneuvers that will be demonstrated on the plane to verify that the alterations to this system function as designed. Post all these test flights, the pilots and the trade unions will need to be convinced the modifications which is going to eliminate the risk. Captains and first officers will require additional training on the changes made by Boeing, and there is also the possibility that the FAA might give permission for a return to service while other global aviation regulators do not. Also, the pressure is from the victim families too, since they are demanding more safety tests before giving a green signal. So that was all about the latest happenings with the Boeing 737 MAX, which is grounded post two fatal accidents. Thanks for watching. I'll upload another video with a new defense update or an aviation update later. Please do subscribe my channel and hit the bell button next to it. And also feel free to leave a comment in the comment section. Thank you.